Now then YouTube, I'm the Toffman and welcome back to some more Football Manager 2014 with Oxenhope Recreation. We are back guys, FIFA has been released and I've left Football Manager out for a little while just so that I can get some FIFA out there for the guys who are really interested in the FIFA stuff. It's mainly what my channel is all about, is that FIFA and Football Manager. I love doing Football Manager, as you well know guys. Now, unfortunately, between this episode and last episode, I've tried to sort out the situation with my wage. I've also tried to even go ahead and say, look, if I can't sort my wage out, give me another year on the contracts of these players. But nothing seems to be working. Even though it tells me it is in the editor, it's not actually working. And that's really, really harsh, because it could be at the end of this season, I'm going to lose my entire squad because I simply can't afford to give them another contract. It could go one of a few ways, because of financial fair play. I don't know if there's some way of turning off financial fair play or whatever. I don't know if I can just... I can't buy anybody. Even if I lose all of my players, and yes, the wage bill is going to go significantly downwards, I can't buy anybody because I'm still under that transfer embargo. So this is going to be a very interesting season, because if I don't get promoted, or, well, even if I get promoted, all of my players are going to disappear, and I'm going to be up shit creek without a paddle, guys. Anyway, in between episodes, let's have a look at this. If you've got any suggestions anyway, by the way, guys, in the comment section below, please, please, please go ahead and let me know. So you guys saw the game against Bury, and it was 5-2. I won that. I had 2 defeats on the bounce, and I haven't had that for a while. Fleetwood Town beating me in the Johnson's Paint Trophy, basically, and then Lincoln City actually beat me 2-0 at away from home. Sorry, in League Two. As you can see, guys, 2 shots on target, 2 fucking goals, and it's a similar thing that happened throughout what's going on here. They seem to score in like one of their only shots on target. Always seems to happen. I don't know if it's because of the tactic that I've got. I'm just susceptible to counter-attack, so when they go on the counter-attack, that's it, they're gonna score, you know what I mean. Luton Town managed to win 2-0, and that was me that had 3 shots on target and 2 goals this time. Hartlepool United 2-1. Carney eventually getting on the score sheet, and Hartlepool. Bristol Rovers 3-1, fantastic stuff. And then last but no means least, Ebbsfleet United. I had 3 goals disallowed. 3 goals disallowed. Also, Grubb injured in the second minute and Jack Thomas injured in the 76th minute. That was not a very, very good day for me, I can tell you that much, guys. But we've got FA Cup first round action today against none other than Leeds United. That is right, guys. Leeds United. So, I think Tariq Fosu on that right-hand side, he's got some real good morale going at the moment. Dean Carmichael hasn't really got that going on. I do apologise, guys, if I sound a bit bunged up. I am. My voice is a bit croaky, and my nose is a bit bunged up, but soldiering on, soldiering on. I don't know where the fuck this guy's come from. He's literally just appeared out of nowhere as this fucking guy. And I've no idea where the hell he's come from. Absolutely no clue, because you can't even look. We can offer him a contract, but I think he's just one of these players that has to come in, because Gary Stevenson's out on loan and he's a goalkeeper. Maybe we needed a goalkeeper for a goalkeeper on the bench for FA Cup matches. I don't know, maybe it's one of those rules. I have no idea. Anyways, I think we're going to give Adam Carney a chance in this one. I think everybody's nice and fit. Billy Gouda the cheese man, he's very inconsistent. Some days he can be fucking spot on, and another day will be absolutely pants. So yeah, it's a little bit inconsistent at the moment for me. Other than that, I believe we should be okay. Good old Grub. Well, I've got 4 injuries here. Meekin's actually out on loan, so that's not a problem. Ryan Mason, who's having a real good time of it as well, he's been playing on that right-hand side instead of Dean Carmichael, because he's got poor morale, and it doesn't matter what I do, he will not go above that. And people with poor morale play worse. So we're going to go ahead and submit that team. That looks pretty large to me. And I need to change my settings up here so that you guys get to see this live. This will be a fantastic game. If we can manage to win this, it'll be a fantastic fucking game. It really will. So here we are. We're kicking off. We are back with some Oxenhope Recreation. It's been a while for me, actually. Tariq Fosu across towards Morris. Carney, look at the space now in the middle there. I think Tariq's offside, is he not? Well, he smashed it straight out Ben Amos anyway, the goalkeeper. Leeds United, interestingly enough, are in League One. So they are only the one league above us. So that's interesting. Morris, Gouda the cheese man. McLaughlin. Morris. There's Tariq Fosu now. Through the middle there. Young can't get the ball. Carney's well offside there. Carney is well off fucking side. It was an F though. It was an F. So four, the previous four goals I've scored have all been offside, including the last game. I literally just played that before I started recording, so I was like, oh, yeah, three goals offside. Thank you for that. Thank you for that, Football Manager. Goo to the cheese, man. See, this is what I mean. We leave ourselves so open at the back there with only the two centre-backs, and they're pretty far apart from each other. Berkeley Agia actually does Pong on this left-hand side. Whips it across into the box. There's nobody there. Hillier picks it up. Morris, Young. And that's going to run straight through to get clear towards Dixon. Look for the DC Cook sign. Teresi on this left-hand side now for Leeds United. Hillier there to do his defensive duties. And this is a great ball down towards Tariq Fosu on this right-hand side. And nearly said left, it wasn't. Morris. Oh, and that cuts it straight across. That is a bad, bad effort on goal. That is... Well, that's my bloody electric meter going off in the background there. Don't worry, guys. I am not burning down. It is just my electric meter. Young. Oh, he's actually come out with that one. Morris. Great ball towards Tariq Fosu now. Oh, and that was an F. He left it a bit too long, I reckon. He should have hit it a little bit sooner than that. For a corner now. Berkeley Agley actually does. Oh. Let's throw in. Come on now, Oxenhope Recreation. Let's be having it. So here we go. McLaughlin. Berkeley. Agia actually does on the right-hand side this time. Gets it in there, but Ben Amos just pops it out of the air. And that's not going to go anywhere. So Amos up the field there towards O'Brien. But Agia's underneath it there. And Hillier's managed to grab that ball. Harriet's now on this left-hand side. He's going to whip it straight across. Oh, Tariq Fosu. That's straight at Ben Amos there. I don't think the cross in the end was a very good cross at all. It was a little bit too close. And, oh, Willis. I'll tell you something. He's done a few of them near post headers. Amos whips it up again. Dixon. Gouda the cheese man. He's there again, cheese man. And he's lost the ball as cheese man. He's got to be careful there. Morris, Young, look at Tariq Fosu's space that he has on that right-hand side now. He's gone past one man, he's gone past two, whips it in towards Carney, across the box. That is a brilliant pass from Carney to Young. And Luke Young gets his 11th goal of the season, and it's in the back of the net now for 1-0 to Oxenhope Recreation. Leeds United, they haven't even had a chance yet. Tariq Fosu, look at that. What a brilliant, brilliant move there, Tariq Fosu. But this is unselfish and a brilliant move at its best there. Adam Carney whipping that ball back, just cutting it back towards Young, and who scores that goal there, which is fantastic. Adam Carney, 6.7 rated, when really he should have a little bit more than that. O'Brien, give Leeds the corner now, whips it straight across the box there, and that was dangerous. That was real, real dangerous there. But Young's picked it up, and look at that. That is terrible stuff. What is he playing at? Nobody knows. So, Berkeley actually, Aguirre actually does. And that's going to get cleared all the way back to the cheese man. McLaughlin. Across to Morris. And here is Young. Brilliant ball in towards Carney. And he cannot fucking hit a band or that bloke at the moment. He's scored a couple of goals on a little bit of a run. But I tell you something, he's a different player this season to what he was last season. He's pants this season. Harriet, Aguirre actually does. All the way back to Bruce Willis. McLaughlin. Oh, he's taking it round two men beautifully there. But then the shot at the end of it, I don't know what he's playing at. He should have cut that across the box there. It's going to be half-time very, very shortly. And we are currently 1-0 up, which is fantastic stuff. Let's get straight on with the second half. No need to do any tinkering or something at half-time. We're doing it all right. We just need to get our shots on target. And that's the big thing at the moment. Getting that ball on target. Ben Hamer whips it up. Dixon, look at this space now. Oh, that was close. Berkeley. Aggie actually does. Here's Harriet. Lovely little ball in towards Young. Is he offside, though? He's not offside. He cuts it back towards Morris. That's 2-0. And Young is involved once again in that goal. Bryn Morris getting his first... Well, is it his first goal? I don't know if it is his first goal or not. Young, I thought he was going to run this out there. He'd left it a little bit too late. Managed to squeeze it in through three defenders from Leeds United. And Morris, it's just there, ready and waiting for it. It's like, yes, please, I'll fucking have this. And then he just taps it in the back of the net. 2-0. Right, it is actually time now to go ahead and do a change here. So Tariq Fosu, I think I'm going to give Dean Carmichael a little bit of a run out on that right-hand side. And we'll leave all the rest for the moment. Tarisi now, Leeds United, looking to hit back. Tarisi whips it straight across the box. I do not know what my defence is doing there. Or my goalkeeper, he should have had that. That's twice that that ball has gone right the way through the six-yard box. The goalkeeper should be dealing with this. Tarisi. Look at this. This is the goalkeeper should easily have that ball. There is no excuse for that. What is he playing at, that goalkeeper? Who knows? So Leeds United with their first chance, would you believe? With their first chance, have managed to get one back. You watch, they fucking have another chance and get another whack and all. Just to piss me off. Oh, this game sometimes. Look at this, Dixon. What a fucking surprise. What did I tell you guys? It's all the time. Stop fucking doing this, Football Manager. Jesus, it's not as if my guys aren't back. Those weren't counter-attacking moves. Those weren't counter-attacking moves at all. This is just bad. What is this? The centre-back, I mean, it's just... I don't know what the hell went on there. Can't explain that, I'm afraid. But I'll tell you something. I'm getting annoyed with this all the time. Gonna bring Carney off and put Michael Shaw on for the last 15 minutes. I can't believe that in seconds my 2-0 lead has just gone through two chances for Leeds United. Carmichael on his right hand side. Bursts into that box, he does. Carmichael, still Carmichael. And it's in the back of the net! Dean Carmichael comes off the bench to score what could be the winner. His second goal of the season, though, because he hasn't been playing much. Ben Amos, actually, inadvertently, that was not going in, I don't think. And Carmichael puts that across. Was it going in? It wasn't. But Ben, it was going straight across the box there towards the far post. It would have been put in anyway, but Ben Amos, he ended up putting that into his own net. Right, it's time to go contain. Waste time, much lower tempo, play safe, be more disciplined, stick to your positions, don't hassle the opponents, and just go. 3 added minutes now. 3-2, Oxenhope Recreation so far. Young with a free kick. What is he doing? He just gives the ball away there. Bruce Willis. Young, Hillier. Morris. It's a lovely little ball in towards Carmichael, but it's gone straight out towards a goal kick there for Leeds United. And that is it. Full time has been blown. Oxenhope Recreation 3, Leeds United 2. Let's go to the analysis. Well, they had 4 shots on target, apparently. I can't even remember seeing those 4 shots, but 2 of those and the only 2 highlights that they had were goals. We had 9 shots on target, 3 goals there, and yes... We've managed to get through to the second round of the FA Cup, guys. We've got there before. Don't forget, we have got there before. We got to the FA Cup third round and lost in the third round. So it's going to be FA Cup second round time next up. God knows when that's going to be. But yeah, what a fantastic result to knock out League One side, Leeds United. That is awesome stuff. So anyway, guys. That's been great. So if you can leave a like on this episode, that'd be amazing if you could. And until next time, I've been the Top Man as always. Stay safe.